Now, we're going to talk about the sidebar. On either side of the board, you'll see this line. By touching that line, I can open the drawer and see the options that are available to me in the sidebar. The first two, home and back, we've already discussed based on the control panel. We'll move on to what's next. Touching the recent tab will show me my recent sources, Android OPS or my laptop plugged into the USB-C port, as well as the recent apps that are available to me. From here, I can simply select an app by touching it. Here, we'll open EasyWrite. Touching the app opens it on the board for me. Back to my recent window, I can also close apps that are open. Here, I'll close AMS files by touching the X below it. I could, if I felt like it, clear all of my apps by touching the Clear All Apps option at the bottom of the screen. Doing that, you'll notice there are no more recent apps that are open. The next option on our sidebar tool is multi-window. Once I have an app open, I can touch my sidebar and select the multi-window option. That will shrink my app into a small floating window that I can move around the screen. I can make it smaller by touching that icon, or I can return it to full screen by touching that one. To go back to multi-window, I simply touch the multi-window option. We move EasyWrite over here. I can do this with multiple apps at one time. Now I have open Chrome, and I'll put Chrome in multi-window mode. I can move it where I want it on my board and position it where I need it to be. If I want to see my apps side by side, there are icons for that here. I'll touch this to open EasyWrite on one side, and here I'll open Chrome on the other. Now my apps are side by side. By touching this icon, I can switch the apps from one side to the other. To close an app, I simply touch the X. To put EasyWrite back in full screen mode, I'll touch that option, and now it's back into full screen. And that's multi-window. Below multi-windows on the sidebar is the quick launch icon. Touching this allows me to scroll through all of the apps on my board and quickly select one. Below that, I'll see the three most recent apps I have open. To quickly move to one, I simply touch it, and there it's loaded for me. Back to the sidebar, I'll next see an option to open EasyWrite directly. Simply touch that, and EasyWrite will open on the board quickly and easily for me. The next option on our sidebar menu is the freeze option, and that's best understood utilizing my laptop. Let me go to the home screen, select my connections tab, and select my laptop. Here, we'll see I have a worksheet that I want the students to use for the next 10 minutes or so. But while they're working, I want to use my laptop. I'll go to the sidebar menu, touch the freeze option, and now you'll see my screen change slightly. I have an outline in blue and the words exit freeze at the bottom. My laptop screen is frozen here. This allows me to go to my laptop and do something else while my students are working on this worksheet. I need to be careful though, before I touch exit freeze, that the screen that comes up is the screen I actually want the students to see. The last option on our sidebar menu is the floating tool. This will be covered under a separate video. That's it for the sidebar. Be sure to look for our other videos to learn more about our premium interactive board.